morning, students.
Good morning, sir.
Okay. So today we will discuss the payment of gratuity act 1972. Okay. Yes. So the gratuity act, it is passed in 1972. It is applicable to all the factories, all the establishments, and to which the our PF Act and all the social security acts are applicable. Likewise, this various statutes like Minimum Wages Act is there, Employment and Social Policy Acts are there. Likewise, it is also a social security act. It means it provides some social security to the employees at the time of retirement and even after the retirement or disablement. Okay, retirement, disablement, or death. Okay, so scope and objectives. Why this act is required? It provides the monetary benefit. The only object is of this act is to provide the monetary benefits to the employees who rendered continuous service to the establishments. Okay, so a monetary award given for services rendered to the employees working in factories, in oil fields, mines, plantations, railway companies, shops, or other establishments. Okay, when it has to be applicable? When upon their superannuation, it is applicable. Means this monetary benefit is given to the employee at their superannuation, at their retirement, at their resignation, or their death or disablement. It means when an employee is departing from the establishment, okay, then only it is applicable, or the employee is will get the gratuity. Okay, so there are some definitions like employee. What an employee means for this act. So in any establishment, okay, mean any person. Employee means any person other than apprentice who is working for wages. Okay, whether it is unskilled, whether it is semi-skilled, or whether it is skilled. Okay, whatever the category of an employee is, whether it is semi-skilled, whether it is unskilled, or whether it is skilled, there is no difference between these for the purpose of this gratuity. Okay, but it should not be an apprentice. There is a clear difference between apprentice and an employee. So employee means that is working for the wages and whose name is registered in the muster roll. Okay, then it becomes employee. But who is an apprentice? Apprentice means the person who is on the technical training. Apprentice means the person who is working with an employee or who is joining an employee for the training period. Okay, so that is apprentice. Okay. Yes. So who is an employer for this act? The employer means related to an establishment, factory, mine, oil field, plantation, port, railway, company, or shop. So these establishment belonging to the central government or the state government, then the employer will be the name whose name is given by appropriate government for the supervision of and control of the employees. That is for employer. Okay, and for any other purpose, the local authority appointed by or any other person appointed by the local authority, that becomes the employer. And in any case, other case, the third point is there, the person who has the authority which has the ultimate control over the affairs of the company. Okay, means who controls the affairs, day-to-day affairs of the company, and who is presumed to be the owner of the company, or who is presumed to control the activities of the company, that is said to be the owner or the employer. Okay. So this is very important. Continuous service. For this act, for the payment of gratuity act, continuous service is very very important. So what is continuous service? Continuous service means uninterrupted service. Okay? Uninterrupted service during the employment period. Whatever the period of employment it is, the service should be uninterrupted. If it is interrupted, then the employee will not be able to get the gratuity. So for the payment of gratuity, to have the right for payment of gratuity, the employee should render the continuous service. Okay? So continuous service means it includes leaves. For continuous service, leaves are allowed. Okay? Leaves are allowed. Leaves for the sake of sickness. If the employee gets sick, then leaves may be permitted. Okay? So that doesn't fall under interrupted service. Okay? If the leaves are taken because of sickness, that also comes to be uninterrupted service. Then leaves because of some accident has happened. Then also the leaves because of the accident. And layoff, strike, etc. What is layoff? Layoff means the situation where employee was ready to work, employee was there on the work, but it is the inability of the employer to provide work for the employees. Then the situation is layoff. When this situation is there, means there is no fault on the part of employees. It is on the fault is on the part of employer itself. So it is termed as continuous service. Okay, then strike period is if the legal strike is there. If illegal strike is there, that may be uninterrupted services may be there or interrupted services may be there. But in case of legal strikes, the services are said to be uninterrupted services. Okay, if it is legal strike. Okay, so now for this interrupted services, the total number of days work should be at least 190 days in mine or coal field. Okay, as you know that total 12 months of working is not there in coal or mine. Okay, so for that 190 days of working should be there, where duration of work is only for 6 months in coal and mine fields. Only 6 months working is there, and in those cases, in case of coal field or mines, 190 days of services it must be there. If it is 190 days services, then it is for uninterrupted services. If it is below 190 days, then it is for interrupted services. Okay, so if an employee works less than 190 days, he will not be considered fit for the payment of gratuity. Okay, so working should be in where the nature of work is there, that only 6 months in a year is working, then 190 days, at least 190 days working should be there. Okay, or more than that. And in every other cases, means the in general whatever the factors surrounding us are there, then 240 days must be there. 240 working days must be there. Means the employee should work for the purpose of this act for continuous service for 240 days in a year. Okay, if it is less than 240 days, then again the status will be of interrupted services. So for the uninterrupted services or continuous services, it should be 240 days in a year. Then in case of seasonal establishments, there other kinds of seasonal establishments are there, like in our area, sugar industry is there. Okay, when you consider the example of sugar industry, where the working may be 7-8 months or seasonal work is there, then for seasonal establishment, 75% of total working days. Suppose the total working days was say 180 days. Okay, so 75% of 180 days must be there for continuous service in case of seasonal establishments. Okay, so 45, that's 45, okay? So 180 minus 45, 135 days. So in case 180 days, suppose 180 days, a seasonal estimate is working for 180 days, then for continuous service, 135 days must be there, the employee should work, okay? So the employee should work at least 135 days in seasonal establishment. Then the continuous service will be there. If it is less than the 190 days or 240 days or 75%, then the continuous service will not be rendered or supposed to be rendered. Okay? So having the right of payment of gratuity, continuous service must be there. For continuous service, uninterrupted service should be there. And for uninterrupted services, 190 days for the mine or coal field establishments, then 240 days in any other areas, and 75% of seasonal establishment must be there. Yes. Okay. So controlling authority, for controlling this authority, the appropriate governments are there. Okay. So the appropriate government, they appoint the authorities under this act. Okay. The government may appoint different controlling authority for the different areas also. Area wise authorities must be there. Yes. So payment of gratuity. When the payment of gratuity is mandatory, for this purpose, an employee have the right to get the payment of gratuity if he has rendered the continuous services for 5 years. At least 5 years he has rendered the continuous services or uninterrupted services. Okay? Then he has the right to get the gratuity. Clear? So he or she has rendered 5 years of continuous services, and after 5 years, it is not so that after 5 years, when he will get on his superannuation, retirement, resignation, death or disablement. Okay? So before this superannuation, before this retirement, before his death, before his disablement or before his resignation, at least 5 years continuous services must be rendered by an employee for the scope or for the object of getting the gratuity from the employer. Okay? Only then he will be eligible to get the gratuity. Okay? If it is less than this 5 years, in case of resignation or in case of this superannuation or retirement, then will not be eligible. But in case of death or in case of this disablement, if it is less than 5 years, then also he will also eligible for payment of gratuity. Okay? Though the general rule is 5 years, but in case of death or disablement, if it is less than 5 years, then also he will be eligible for gratuity. Okay? Though general rule is 5 years continuous services. Okay? Clear? So in case of death or disablement by accident or disease, the employee is under obligation to pay the gratuity amount to the employee's nominee. Yes, in case of death or disablement, right? It is very simple. When the employee got retirement or resigned, he himself is eligible for the gratuity. But in case of his death or disablement, if it is not able, if he is not, he or she is not able to go to the offices or whatever, so, or in case of his death, so the nominee, one nominee has to be there. After he or she, means every employee, when he complete 1 year of services, he has to give the name of his nominee to the employer. It is must, it is compulsory that employer should get one name as nominee from his family. That in case of death or in case of disablement, the nominee can receive the gratuity amount. Okay? So nominee must be there. Nominee or legal heir. Uttaradhikari. Okay? Next. Yes.